Hi, it's Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to diagnose whether a special MRI can diagnose CCJ instability. So CCJ instability is upper neck instability, and it means that the ligaments that hold the head on, and there are many of them described here, are either damaged or loose. And there are two types of imaging that can suggest CCJ instability. One is static non-moving imaging, and the other is dynamic. Now, we're going to be focused on the static version of MRI. There is a moving MRI or one that can be done with motion, but today we'll focus on the static MRI. And regrettably, a routine neck MRI doesn't show the CCJ area well. In fact, it doesn't even include cuts that go high up into that area. So this is the block that they usually acquire, kind of from C2 down to T1. Now the CCJ is above there, so they're not getting much information about the CCJ in a routine MRI. They're just not looking in the right place. It's on there in some of the cuts, but in other cuts, it's not at all. So the only way to get accurate MRI information about the CCJ is to use a head coil. So we have two kinds of coils shown here. And a coil is the thing that gets information about the body for the MRI. So this is, your head would go up here, your neck goes through this neck coil, then your shoulders are down there. So it's gathering information about your neck and not as much about this area, which is above the coil. This head coil here, you can see, goes around the head and the upper neck, so it's going to gather more information. In addition, the strength of the MRI signal is measured by something called Tesla. Now, that's not the car guy. That's actually refers back to Nikola Tesla at the turn of the century. And this is a measurement of magnetic field strength. So a higher magnetic field strength, like a 3 Tesla, is better than a 1.5 or a 1 or a 0.5. In addition, you need very thin slices and a specialized MRI sequence to show these ligaments well. So what does this type of very special MRI show? Well, it can show the alar ligaments like that are shown here in some detail, not fantastic detail like we can see the ACL ligament in the knee, but pretty good detail. And there's a grading scale for these ligament injuries proposed by a neuroradiologist by the name of Crokinus. And there's some controversy whether or not the changes seen in these ligaments on MRI are in fact related to injury. And this goes back and forth and has gone back and forth. The bottom line is it depends on who you look at and when. But like all CCJ measurements with imaging, the results of these MRIs need to be combined with history exam and a response to treatment to get to a diagnosis. So you can't ever use an image, or it's very rare in medicine that you can use a single image and say, aha, that's it. Certainly not in this kind of problem. So for more information, contact the CCJ Instability Institute at ccjinstability.com. Thanks so much for listening and have a great day.